Greetings, everybody. Good to see you again. Now, for this video, we're going to have a tutorial in which we're going to learn how to build what is called an image bot in MIT App Inventor. And what it is, it's an example of generative AI, but unlike the one we did before on ChatGPT, this is not based on a chat, but rather it's about creating images based on prompts given by the user. It's a really wonderful example of generative AI. Now, before we do anything coding-wise, I would like to quickly do a demo for you. So let me share my screen. So I'm gonna share my screen and we're going to see an example of this app. So let me move this a little bit out of the way here. Sorry about that, 1 second. Okay, so we can move this here and I would like to also make sure that I am visible. So let me show myself here at the corner. Okay, super. So here is the app that we're going to end up creating today. There's a canvas here where the image is going to be pasted. There's a speak button. This is where the prompt spoken by the user is going to be pasted. And when you click the create image button, it will create the image on the canvas by sending the prompt to OpenAI, which uses the DALL-E interface. Okay, so here's an example. I'm going to say, kitten with wings. Okay, it gave me, so I spoke the prompt. Now I'm going to say, create the image. It's going to send my prompt to OpenAI DALL-E. And what's going to happen is in a second, we should be able to see what a kitten that has wings looks like. Okay. So you could let your imagination run wild. You could have all kinds of combination of animals and objects and so on and so forth. But this is the interface we are trying to create today. So let me quit that. So we're gonna create a new project. So go to where it says start new project. Okay. And I'm gonna call this image bot, okay? So let's see what happens when I do that. So I'm going to call my project ImageBot. Super. Now we're going to have a number of components here that we're going to start putting. The first thing we need to put is a canvas. So you find that in the palette, if you go down to where it says drawing and animation, and I grab the second component there called the canvas. Initially, as you can see, it's very small. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually give it a height and a width. For reasons that I don't want to get too much into, it turns out that DALL-E works best with a certain number of pixels. In this case, we're going to use 256 by 256. You could also have specified 512 by 512. That's another pixel size that DALL-E accepts. But we're going to go with a small pixel size right now. So that's our canvas. And I would like everything to be centered nicely on my screen. So I go to screen component hierarchy here. And I grab where it says align horizontal. I make it centered. So we will see our canvas nicely centered. Now, underneath that, I'm going to have a couple of buttons and a text box region. So let's go to user interface in the palette. And I'm going to grab a button. I'm going to drop it there. I'm going to grab a text box and drop it underneath that. And then finally, I'm going to need one more button for right now. That's going to be for creating the image. Okay, so let's actually work with these. So the first one is going to be called the speak button, similar to what we have done in the case of the ChatGPT. So I'm going to call this the text of that. I'm going to change it to speak. Okay. And like before, I would like to make this to be green in color and rounded in shape. Okay. And I just realized I forgot to color my screen. So I'm going to click on the screen and wake up its properties. Again, I'm going to stick to orange color as my background so I have some consistency. So I have now a nice speak button. I change its text here and I change its color and shape. Now I need to rename this button to speak button so that in a minute when we are doing our coding, we are able to remember what this button is. So I change that to that. Now we come to our text box. What I would like to have here is I want to have it as wide as possible. So I'm going to click on its property width and make it fill parent. Okay. If you're anticipating a long description, you can actually come here and select the multi-line option like we did in the ChatGPT example. Okay. So because this is going to be the only text box we have, I'm not going to rename it, but you could if you wanted to. Now we come to our button two. Let's rename that to create image button. So create image button. And I'm going to change its text to create image. Actually, let me capitalize that just for consistency, create image. And just for, again, consistency, I'm going to make it rounded and I'm going to make it green in color. Okay. So we have everything we need, I think. So the graphical user interface is ready, but like before, we need to have some non-visible components. The first non-visible component I need is, like before, a speech recognizer, which is available in the media. So I grab speech recognizer, drag and drop it, and it lands in the speech in the non-visible component part as before. Now, two other components we're going to need. One of them is the image bot. Again, it's in the experimental. You grab and drag and drop. It's going to, again, give you a dialogue telling you this is an experimental component. Just okay that. We are also going to need in the user interface, if you click on the palette on the user interface, a notifier. Because sometimes it takes a while to generate the images, we want to basically tell the user the progress we're making. So we just need to be able to communicate that. It will also land in the non-visible components. Okay. So we have everything we need. Now, for the ImageBot component, again, it is okay. It should be okay to have your API key empty here. If you have your open AI API key, please paste it here so you can have unlimited access to OpenAI. But normally, you should be able to leave this empty because you should have some allocated quota for you that allows you to work for free without paying. I know that I'm going to need to copy paste my API key. So I'm just going to put it right here. And you could leave the default size as 2256 as we discussed before. All righty, now we are ready for coding. So I go to blocks. And I try to sort of like imagine the sequence of events here. Basically, let's go back to here. So we need to tell what happens when you click the speak button. We need to tell what happens when you click the create image button, okay? So those are two events I know must be handled. So I go to speak button when clicked, and I go to create image button when clicked. And I will then figure out what needs to happen afterwards. So when the speak button is clicked, let us start by clearing the text box text. So if there was anything in there before, it should be cleared. So let's actually go to that and go to set text box text. And if you notice, I grabbed some random setter here because I can always go to its menu and select the option I want, in this case, text box text. So I'm gonna set that to the empty text box as we have done before, okay? And then we go to the speech recognizer blocks, and I say speech recognizer.getText. So the voice recording of the user now goes to Google, and Google is going to produce a text out of that, and it's going to invoke the block here called after getting text block. And what we would like to do is we would like to set text box text to the result that is returned by Google. So what I do is I right click on this and duplicate that, and I can just snap it back to here, get rid of the empty string here. And what I need is I need to hover over where it says result. This is the result coming back from Google. So I select that and I snap it directly into the socket right here. Okay. So right now what happened is we have, we pressed the speak button. The user's speech went back to Google. It returned with the text and it got pasted into the text box space right here. Now, what is going to happen is the user is going to then press create image button. And let's see what's going to happen thereafter. Now, when the create image button is clicked, we first would like to make sure that the text box text is not empty. We don't want to send an empty string to OpenAI and, you know, confuse things. So to be able to do that, what we're going to do is, what we're going to need is an if-then block, a conditional, that will test that the text box text is not empty. So the way we do that is you go to logic, you grab a not block, so not, and then you go to text blocks, the one that is called is empty. So we are basically saying is we don't want the text box text to be empty. So I go to text box text, this one right here. So I'm saying make sure the text box text is not empty. All right. Okie doke. Now, what's going to happen is we're going to send to OpenAI the description. Let's go to ImageBot blocks and grab the one that says create image. So we're going to select that. And the description we're going to send to OpenAI is actually living in the text box text. So I am going to duplicate that and snap into here. Okay. Now, there's actually a step we need to do before this. Because it takes a while for the text to travel to OpenAI and, you know, produce an image and the image come back to us, the user may get impatient and confused if anything is happening at all. This is why we're going to have the notifier. So if you click on the notifier blocks, there's an option there called show progress dialog. So we're going to grab that block. And what we're going to say is we're going to need a text block here. Actually, I'm going to need two of these. So I'm going to quickly duplicate that. So the title is going to be something like, please wait. So this is asking the user to be patient. So please wait. Okay. And then the message can be something like, you know, we are generating your image. So generating your image. Okay. So this is just a way of communicating with the user so they don't grow impatient. Okie doke, we're almost there. So now what happens is the image bot is going to return with an image. So we are going to have this block invoke. So when image bot image created returns with a file, we need to, first of all, cancel the dialogue created by the notifier. So there's an option here that says dismiss progress dialog. So we snap it right here. What we need to do is we need to set the canvas background image, let's get rid of this thing here, to the file name returned by OpenAI. All righty, believe it or not, we are done. You can add, as we'll see in a minute, more advanced features, but this is good enough. So what I'm going to do is I am going to quickly test all of this. So let's reset everything. I generate a QR code. I invoke my visor here so I can scan this, okay? So I'm going to quickly scan this code and we'll see what happens thereafter. Oops. Okay, so I have my interface here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to press the speak button and I'm going to give a description. So let's say something like cat in astronaut costume floating in space filled with stars. Okay, so I press the create image button and we'll see how much of what I gave as a prompt is going to be created in my image. So here you see it's a space filled with stars. Here I have my cat floating in an astronaut costume. So it's pretty accurate. Now you could now press speak button and give another prompt, or if you keep pressing the create image here, button here, it will actually take the same prompt, but give you each time a new random image. So let's do that. Let's see what's going to happen if I click on it again. Okay. So now you see another version of that, and you could keep doing that. And really, your imagination, you know, can run wild here as you try different prompts and see what kind of images that you get. Now, right now, there is no way in the app that we've created to save this image in a way it's accessible, like, for example, so that you can post on social media. So what I'm going to quickly show you is if you go to our website, which is appinventor.mit.edu, you're going to see towards the middle of the page a bunch of tutorials, and one of them is the Artificial Intelligence with App Inventor page. There are a lot of different tutorials here that you might enjoy looking, but somewhere in the middle is the ChatGPT app and the ImageBot app, but the intermediate level of these. So it's more advanced than the version we have created. So let me click on the ImageBot app so you can see what the interface looks like. It looks a lot like what we have, except in addition to the create button, there is a share button. What the share button does is it actually accesses this image file that you have on your app and allows you to share it on your social media or email it to your friends, etc. So I really urge you to look at the more advanced versions of both the ImageBot and also the, let me show you the chatbot also. Also the chatbot, you'll see it's a more advanced version of the chatbot that we have created where you could, you know, set some system roles, etc. But it's a good follow-up to the tutorial that we have created here. Alrighty, so I'm going to stop sharing. I hope this was interesting for you. I hope you can start anticipating the possibilities. There's so many wonderful things you can create with these tools. I hope you enjoy. I hope to see you at another tutorial. All the best.